Hey guys, welcome to the intro. Please like, comment, and subscribe. If you'd like to come hang out with us in between videos, come check out the Discord. Also, through the magic of editing, let's give you an update on where we stand with the current suggestions for the next deep dive. Cool. Thanks, future me. Today, I am so excited. We are getting into the first full album, Dystopia, The Tree of Language. The album, being a full album, is quite large, so we're actually going to split this one into two different reaction videos, with part one being today and part two being tomorrow. So we are going to get through the first half of the album today, all the way up through Jazz Bar, and then we will finish out the back half of the album tomorrow. All right. Let's get into it, because I don't want to wait anymore. All right, cool. So here is the intro to Dystopia, The Tree of Language. That was interesting. So the first thing that I kind of noticed was like there was like this very crunchy, dark vibe at the start of the intro, and it progressively got lighter and almost felt like more hopeful as the song went on, and then it kind of bell curved its way back down to a sadder sound at the end, almost as if they started out in this dystopia, were searching for their utopia, and then realized that they didn't find it at the end, mirroring the journey of the whole like set of title tracks a little bit. But it was a cool intro. I really dug it. Let's get into our first song of the album, which is Scream. As Scream is a title track and we've seen the music video, we know the lyrics, we're gonna go right into a dance practice. It's interesting that they still included the dancer with the mask on, or Handong, in this, because I believe this is when she's still in China, or this is the when she started, like at the start of the time she was in China. But again, Dreamcatcher doing Dreamcatcher things with the choreo, the layers of verticality, the space, the member in the center, controlling the dancers on the outside. I think this might be the first dance practice we've seen with other backup dancers in it. So that's kind of neat. Ooh, I forgot about that lift.
Oh.
gotta say, I've been really impressed with you know, like how they work with the backup dancers in this one. It's very seamless, and it is a little I'm not used to seeing co-ed backup dancers on K-pop tracks, but I'm liking it. They add another level of dimension to the choreo. Ooh. All right. So like the two lines of dancers of the girls on either side of Sua like just draws you right to her, and moving back through it, even like, man, their choreo is so good. Ugh. Bro in the hat almost got his head stepped on. Kill it, Sua. Breakdown choreo in this song is so good. Is weirding me out a little bit that they're not like. Maybe they are. Maybe it's just my eyes. Never mind. It's because of the lean. I was like, they're not quite on center, but they are. It's just because they're leaning a little bit, it tricks my eyes. Awesome choreo. I think Dreamcatcher maintains a sense of space in their choreo better than just about any group. They control the floor, they control the stage, and it just oozes this kind of like power from it. That I just adore. So let's get into next the Dreamcatcher scream from the Crossroads concert with a live band.
Thank you.
Oh, Handan's back for this. Nice. Is she? Maybe not. Maybe she's not. Oh, yeah, she is. Good. I was kind of hoping the mix would have the instrumentals a little stronger, because it felt like that drop didn't feel as strong as it did in the studio version. Kill it, Guyon. Oh, that drum fill. Hold on, I gotta go back. So was killing it and I was headbanging. Yeah, that move is so good. Go off, guitar player. Like way back in the mix there, that guitar player was like really shredding. Also, hey, Gio. It was really cool to see the OT7 version of this, but let me finish this track out. Get the ending fairy look. There we go. Okay. But yeah, it was really nice to see an OT7 version and that like Handan got some lines in there as well. I was curious to see, you know, if they did do an OT7 version, if she would just dance with them or if they would actually have some lines for her as well. And it was great to see that she did. Right, okay. Our next one is our first song that I don't know off of the album, Tension. I know there's an English version of this one as well, but I think the version on the album is the Korean version. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think we're going with that one. Let's go. Ooh. We'll be right back.
이렇게 짜여진 너만의 그 안엔 한 번의 실수도 너무 큰 독인걸 이제 망설이지만 갇혀있지만 붙들고 나가야 해 Break the wall Oh no 어느새 멈춰버린 time 딱 너만 빼고 바쁘게 시간이 흘러가 항상 모든 게 완벽할 수는 없어 괜찮아 넌 지금 잘하고 Ooh.
Okay, so a couple things that stood out to me. One, like, that's a real bop. Love that song. Really excited to eventually get to see the English version of it because I think maybe that'll be an OT7 version. Not really sure. But the few things that struck me were that we didn't get a rap verse in that, and Dami kind of got like this weird onomatopoeia sounding line for most of the song. That was pretty much all she got through the parts. Gaeyeon had some really cool belty moments in the song that like we don't typically get from her. When we get her vocal, it's usually this sweet melodic part of the pre-chorus. We don't get it, or like that kind of almost rap-esque bits in Scream. We don't typically get like that heavy belting kind of sound from her, because usually that comes from Yuyeon and Shion. So it was really an interesting switch up to see her get some of those parts as well and split those with Shion. Yeah, I dug this. This was a really cool song. The instrumentation was like heavy but not overpowering. Yeah, all right, let's see what we got in terms of our special clip for attention. We have a concert clip from the live Halloween concert with a live band.
Oh, my God.
They got the light sticks out. Is this the encore for the this online concert? I wonder. But the band is killing it. Guyon killing it live, but like the live band makes such a difference with their live performances. Oh my goodness. Do a hamming it up. Adorable. I thought that was a lot of fun. I think that is going up there for me on my list of B-sides that I think are like in the top tier of Dreamcatcher's discography, up there for me with like Wonderland. And I've been like slow, like July 7th has been growing on me a lot recently. I've been listening to that song a lot, but I think Tension is up there. And this performance of it was so much fun. I think my biases over there were killing it. Yuhyun and Guyon were absolutely slaying that song. Sua just being a agent of chaos throughout the whole thing, getting to hear Handong's lines in it was fun. Overall just a really good time. Let's get into our next one, which is Red Sun. I'm worried. I know this one is choreographed by Sua, and we have the special clip to start us off. So, Red Sun special clip, let's go. Oh, they all look great. Right now? Yeah, okay.
Oh,
clean the mirror. 차가운 안개가 널 감싸면 기억하지 못할까. 눈 감아냈어.
Yeah, so
don't know why, don't know why. 네 앞을 막은 wall 벗어날 수 없어. You don't know 스스로 꺼내든 칼날에 넌 위험에 빠질 거야. 석양이 지고 어둠이 오면 너도 알게 될 거야. 이곳의 room oh. 시작점에 널 데려다 줄게. 또다시 새로운 game come wow. 타락한 그 맘이 커질수록 in a mirror 차가운 안개가 널 감싸면 기억하지 못할 거야. 눈 감아봤어. Oh, na, na, na. 반복되는 trap at night. I leave you. Oh, na, na, na. 몸부림치는 널 보면 웃겨. Rest on, rest on, rest on. 빠져들어 rest on.
More like get some behind the scenes. You can't keep it together. So I'm kind of surprised it wasn't nearly as spicy as some of other choreographed stuff that we've seen from Sua, but it does have some like hallmarks of hers that I'm starting to recognize when you get Sua choreography. And it's this, there's these intricate shifting shapes that like you get that like the X pattern that we saw in Damien, where the one member came back and then the each side kind of formed an X behind them. In this, they were doing a lot of that, the V shapes that would turn then into a circle and then into another formation from there. Like these very complicated formations. I'm no dancer and I don't really study dance, so I don't really have a good vocabulary on how to explain it, but I was mesmerized through that whole thing. I thought there was going to be lyrics on this because it was a special clip. I was wrong. So I think rather than do another special clip, I will pull up a lyrics video for this so that we can get an idea of what the song was about. But yeah, that was really cool. All right, give me a second to pull that other, the lyrics video up. All right, Red Sun lyrics. Before we begin, I am gonna pause throughout this. I will understandably kind of try and figure out the lyrics, etc. Because I didn't really pay as much attention to the production or the instrumentation as I probably should have during the special clip because I was so focused on Sua's choreography. Right. Let's go. I'm not really sure what this is about yet. So, like, they're talking about Red Sun kind of like going down and being able to tormenting you before sleep, maybe? Is it like literally about not being able to go to sleep because of stress and being unable to get this person out of their mind? Maybe? You don't know 스스로 꺼내든 칼날에 넌 위험에 빠질 거야 석양이 지고 어둠이 오면 너도 알게 될 거야 이곳의 rule of 시작점에 널 내려다 줄게 또다시 새로운 game come roll 타락한 그 맘이 커질수록 자꾸만 바뀌는 Yeah, I'm pretty lost, I think, in terms of like what this one's about. If somebody in the comments wants to explain what the meaning behind this one might be, I'm not really sure. Banger song. I have no idea what it's supposed to mean. it's a really vibey song too, which is cool. It's not like heavy driving, it's not a ballad, it's kind of this weird vibey middle ground. That makes for a really interesting listen. Cool B-side. I'm really liking the album's variety so far, you know, between the title track of Scream, the similarly heavy driving beat of Tension, and now this like more vibey sound from Red Sun. Really loving that every song has felt like completely different from one another. And next up, we have Let me get back to my playlist. So give me a second. Editing time. All right. So now we have Black or White. I am excited. We're going to do lyrics first. I'm excited. I think I got the one that I saw from the guide where there was like a transformation of their clothes mid performance, but I'm not 100% sure. And it's on one of the shows. So if it gets blocked, it'll be filtered and the unfiltered version will be on Patreon for free. So yeah, let's get into the lyrics for Black or White. Ruby. Killed that. Sorry for pausing on the first watch, but like, oh, Tommy killed that. I need to hear that again. That might be my favorite Dami rap ever. That song was really, really interesting. The chorus felt way out there. like for a Dreamcatcher song. Like it felt very different from most of the other choruses that I had heard from them. And it had this kind of real funk vibe to it, which I was here for. And then the ad libs that we were seeing near the end in that final chorus were just wild. Dami's rap, I think I said as we replayed it, is probably my favorite. It's up there anyway with maybe New Days as my favorite rap from her. I am wondering when we're gonna get another like full Gaion rap verse. That would be fun. But her vocals in this song particularly were awesome. So yeah, let's get into that live clip and hopefully it doesn't get blocked. This subtitle, hold on, subtitles, settings, and we not, no, don't want Arabic, so we'll turn subtitles off for this one. Things we'll go back and watch a little more. The choreo is stunning. They look great in these white suit outfits. And I don't think it is the one that I had seen from the guide, but I'm okay with it. It's great. All right, let's go back a little bit so we don't miss anything. Swag. Wait, that eyebrow move from Shion. Let's see that again. Yeah.
Black,
Oh, ending fairy time. Oh, we got a little bit of scream from Dami there. All right. The choreo for that is so fun. It's very vibey, very funky, and kind of like, I don't know how to describe it. It was just, Dreamcatcher, why are you so good? I'm running out of things to say about how good they are. This isn't the version that I thought it was going in. So if anybody happens to know the one where they edit in between and transition between black outfits to, or white outfits to black outfits in the middle of the song, let me know, because I do want to watch that, because it looked cool when I saw it on the guide. Anyway, that is Black or White. And our next song is our last one for this part of the album, Jazz Bar. I am very excited about this because I know Jazz Bar may or may not be the equivalent of No Dot from the last tour, in that they got very spicy on stage. We have one of those clips as our special clip for this one. So buckle up, but we're gonna do our lyrics video first. Let's go. Oh yeah. I'm a big jazz fan, so I'm down for the jazzy vibe.
Feel it too.
Remember when I said Tension was up there with being with Wonderland as one of my favorite B-sides? This is my favorite B-side. Like, this song makes my heart happy. Like, I love the jazzy vibe. The vocals are impeccable. It's just, production makes me smile. This is me in my happy place, in terms of, music I've heard from them so far. I also think that it just makes me want to hear them do a cover of B2B's Blue Moon. I know they do a Blue Moon cover, but it is not that blue. But I would love to hear them do like the cinema version rendition of B2B's Blue Moon, because, or maybe mash it up with Jazz Bar, because the two of them are both very jazzy tracks, and I think that would be a heck of a lot of fun. Right. So now here's the part I'm worried about. How in the world did that get to be No Dot level spicy? I'm not sure, but we're going to find out, because the next is a live clip from, it's either Toronto or Cincinnati. I can't remember which one I grabbed, but let's find out. Nashville. I was wrong on all counts. Okay. All right. So we got Nashville and Jazz Bar. So let's go. Right, it is a fan cam, so shaky / blurry quality. Don't worry about it. But I imagine they already know what's coming, because this is later into the tour. There's a full bar behind them. Oh, Kion's already worried. Kion running away. She's like, no. Oh. Dami. Kion is already just like, nope, running away, staying far away from Sua. Uh-oh. Sua, whoa. Oh. Tommy over there like, oh, excuse me. Kion, it looks so nervous throughout this performance. She's over here like biting her fingernails. Calming you's head. Dami. Like, no, oh, okay. Alright, so I don't know if that was as spicy as No Dot, but I could see how it escalated throughout the tour stops, it being pretty wild. Again, though, I think that song is definitely my favorite B-side I've heard so far. It's so good. It's so good. Alright, so that was the first half, the first six songs of the album, and in the next half we'll get to the rest, excluding the instrumental for Scream. So there'll be seven songs on the back half of this one, starting with, I believe, Sahara. So see you tomorrow with the back half. Bye.